A DIY FM transmitter antenna dipole equivalent is what we are building today. This is a quarter wave ground plane antenna, which actually has the same length radiator as a half wave dipole antenna, which actually is a quarter wave antenna with a vertical ground plane. So the signal strength radiated is exactly the same as a half wave dipole antenna. The antenna can be used for transmitting and receiving across the FM band of 88 to 108 MHz. This antenna can also be used for much higher frequencies, as the antenna length is easily adjustable to reach all the way up to 400 MHz. If you use shorter telescopic antennas, then the frequency can go way beyond even 500 MHz. The difference between this antenna and a dipole is that a dipole is semi-directional, so it points a sizable chunk of the signal in one direction. The quarter-wave antenna, on the other hand, puts out an almost perfectly omnidirectional signal. In other words, the signal goes equally in all directions. This quarter-wave antenna is top-mounted and not side-mounted like a dipole, so there is no reflector. This applies whether the antenna is used as a receiving antenna or a transmitting antenna. This design is intended for low power transmitting and is intended to be portable for short-term broadcasts. It's perfect for events and for testing as well. It can be folded down to be transported more easily. The antennas you'll be using are telescopic antennas, which you can get from old TV antennas or those used by portable FM radios. The reason for this is that it makes it very easy to adjust the length of the antennas to match the wavelength for the frequency of the signal that you will be transmitting or receiving. Let's get to the construction of the antenna. These are the parts that you will need, and here are the tools that you will need. To start the build, you will need a small square piece of aluminium or aluminum. Drill a hole in the center with a 10mm drill bit. Drill a hole near the corners with a 5mm drill bit. Leave enough space around the hole so that it does not weaken it and break the corner off. Drill two more holes to the one side of the aluminium plate. These need to be measured out by using two L-shaped brackets that will form the stand of the antenna. First, tape two L-shaped brackets together and then place the holes of the bracket about halfway between the center hole and the edge of the plate. Mark these holes with a marker, then drill these holes with a 5mm drill bit. With all the holes drilled, your plate should look like this, and you can begin assembling the antenna. Now start with the center screw or bolt. This is a 2mm wide and 20mm long screw. First, take the long screw or bolt for the top radial antenna and place an eyelet on it, then a metal washer, then a rubber grommet or washer that are often used in water taps. Then push the screw through the bottom of the plate through the bigger center hole. Then put a rubber grommet or rubber washer on top of that, and then put a metal washer on top of that. Now bring in your top antenna and screw it onto the screw until it makes a tight fit. Don't over-tighten it, but make sure that it doesn't wobble. Now place the L-shaped bracket onto the plate using screws that are countersunk to be flat and not raised above the surface of the metal plate. Put the nuts on underneath. Now place an eyelet onto one of the screws with a small piece of wire on it, and place another nut over it. Tighten these up a bit. Now take your coaxial cable and solder the center of the coaxial cable to the center eyelet. Then solder the coaxial braiding to the other eyelet with a separate short piece of wire on it. Now take the cable off the antenna and tape it up, leaving the eyelets exposed that can still reach the screws. Put the eyelets back on the screws as before and tighten up the screws. Be sure to put cable ties over the coaxial cable and tighten them to the L-shaped bracket. This will stop the cable flopping around and breaking off the eyelet connections. Now take your four hinged telescopic antennas and place them underneath the plate, and using countersunk screws, screw in the radials. Now adjust the radials to the correct length for the frequency you will be using. To calculate the length correctly, use the frequency wavelength calculator in the description. The ground plane radials should be 12% longer than the top radial length. So if your antenna radial is 75 centimeters, then the ground plane radials should be 84 centimeters. Put some tape over the section joins to stop it changing length by accident. Make sure each ground plane radial is at a 45 degree angle. You might have to tighten the hinge screws if the radial antennas droop down. Now, to attach the antenna to a pole, place the U-bolt clamps or hose clamps over the vertical part of the L-shaped brackets. Then insert the pole and tighten it up. Make sure the top of the pole is below the metal plate. Cable tie the coaxial cable to the pole and then test for a connection between your cable center and the top radial antenna. And then the outer braiding side of the cable to the plate and ground planes. Test that there is also no short between the center of your cable and the braiding. You can either run the RG58 cable to your transmitter or receiver, or you can put a connector on the end of the short RG58 coaxial cable and attach a much better cable to it if you are running a long length of cable. RG58 is only good for about 5 meters. For lengths longer than that, use a higher quality cable. This antenna is designed for low power, so do not connect high power transmitters to it. If you're going to transmit with this antenna, make sure you do so safely and legally. I do not recommend using a transmitter with an output power rating higher than 5 watts. Just remember that using this antenna, along with all the other antennas on this channel, are done entirely at your own risk. Make sure you know how to use the tool safely and correctly. Also make sure you know, understand, and abide by the laws of your country. To learn more about antennas, broadcasting, transmitters, and presenting, click on a video here that you like.